Warning: this procedure produces toxic gases and should be done outside or in a fume hood. Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to make crude aluminum nitrate nonahydrate that we'll need in upcoming videos. At first, you might think that we can just add aluminum directly to nitric acid. Unfortunately, as seen here, aluminum does not react with nitric acid due to a passivation layer that forms on the surface. We need to go through a roundabout method to get to aluminum nitrate. First, start with 20 milliliters of 6 molar solution of hydrochloric acid. This can be made by mixing equal amounts of concentrate hydrochloric acid and distilled water. Then drop in 1 gram of aluminum foil. As you can see, aluminum reacts very vigorously with hydrochloric acid. This will produce aluminum trichloride. Now we want aluminum nitrate, so to convert it, we add 20 milliliters of concentrated 15.6 molar nitric acid. The nitric acid reacts with the chloride ions in the aluminum trichloride and oxidizes them to nitrosyl chloride. This bubbles out of solution and leaves behind aluminum nitrate. This gas is rather toxic, and the mixture should be left in a fume hood or outside to dry. The conversion from chloride to nitrate will proceed on its own. To speed up the reaction, you can also boil the mixture. The brown gas is the nitrosyl chloride decomposing and producing nitrogen dioxide and chlorine. You can tell the reaction is over when the gas clarifies, indicating it's no longer producing nitrosyl chloride and nitrogen dioxide. At this point, take it off heating and once again let it dry. You may need to use a desiccator bag we showed you in a previous video. I found the desiccator bag was a must-have in the summer when the ambient humidity was very high. You cannot simply boil down the mixture because aluminum nitrate decomposes if heated when dry. Now, when it's dry, it should be a white solid. If it's a yellow solid, it means there's still leftover chloride in the product, and you should add more nitric acid and water to completely react it. Now, another point. You might run into a situation where the solution doesn't crystallize even after a couple of weeks. Similar to hot ice, you need to initiate it. The best way I found was to simply connect an air hose or a strong fan and blow air into the mixture, accelerating drying and initiating crystallization. Once it's initiated, put it into the desiccator bag for complete drying. Eventually, you'll have crude aluminum nitrate nonahydrate. It's not pure enough for our purposes, but we'll show purification techniques in an upcoming video. Before you get any ideas, you cannot use aluminum nitrate nonahydrate for pyrotechnics. Here is a mixture of sugar and aluminum nitrate nonahydrate. As you can see, it doesn't burn, but instead turns into this rubbery mass of carbon and aluminum oxides. Instead, we'll be using aluminum nitrate nonahydrate to make glow-in-the-dark powder. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, rate, and comment. Oh, and before you ask why you can't just mix both acids, the answer is you could, but the combined acids partially decompose before they react with the aluminum, so you'll end up wasting more acid to dissolve the same amount of foil. Therefore, to save costs, you have to go through the two-step method in order to make aluminum nitrate.